Good morning to all. This is Professor R. Sudha, M. Visalakshi, Assistant Professor, Department of Electrical and Electronics Engineering in Thandai Periyar Government Institute of Technology. Welcome to e-learning class. In this video lecture, we are going to see about the different types of electromagnetic relays, which is a continuation of previous video lecture. So these are the topics we are going to cover: the shaded pole relay, water meter relay, induction cup type relay. So in this induction type relay, it is also called as a magnitude relay, which works on the principle of induction motor or energy meter. And in this, the torque produced in this relay due to the interaction of flux in rotor by the another flux. So here two flux with same frequency and displaced in the time and space. So this is your electromagnetic induction type relay. So three different: shaded pole, water meter, induction cup type. And this is our torque equation of induction type relay. Here this which I told us two different flux, right? So phi 1 will be equal to phi 1 max sin omega t, and phi 2 will be maximum flux sin omega t plus alpha. So current producing will be equal to change in flux with respect to the time. So phi 1 we are going to substitute here. So phi 1 max sin omega t, and after differentiating this term, we will get phi 1 max sin omega t as a cos omega t. Similarly for current I 2, so directly proportional to change in flux with respect to time. And phi 2 will be phi 2 max instead of sin, cos omega t plus alpha. So the respective force obtained in this relay is directly proportional to the phi 1 I 2, and for force to phi 2 I 1. So we are going to calculate the net force at the instant will be F 2 minus F 1 will be directly proportional to the net force. So we, from the previous equation, phi 2 I 1 minus phi 1 I 2. So we know what is phi 2 here and phi 1 here. We are going to substitute the value for phi 2 as well as I 1 minus phi 1 max sin omega t, and I 2 value is phi 2 maximum cos of omega t plus alpha. So making a common term, that is phi 1 max and phi 2 max, as cos omega t plus alpha, it is common, into cos omega t minus sin omega t cos omega t plus alpha. So this is our respective identity which we come across: sin A sin cos B minus sin B cos A. So that this term which will be sin alpha, or it will be cancelled, okay, sin omega t sin alpha minus sin omega t cos. So finally we obtained as phi 1 maximum phi 2 maximum into sin alpha, or phi 1 phi 2 sin alpha. Here this phi 1 phi 2 represents the RMS value of the respective flux. So some points to be noted for this type of relays: here the phase angle alpha between the flux will be greater than the net force applied to the disk, and the maximum force which will produced when the two flux will be 90 degree out of phase, and the direction of net force, that is F equal to F, directly proportional to F2 minus F1, and the motion direction of the motion of disk will depend upon which the flux is leading. So these are the main points from the above equation we derived. Next type is a shaded pole type induction relay, and this shaded pole induction type relay, aluminium disc which is free to rotate in an air gap of an electromagnet. So here this is our coil, this is the coil representation, and this is our disc rotating, and this is our shading ring point. Okay, so this is our shading point and flux producing. So a pole face of each pole is shaded with the help of copper band called shading ring. So this is our copper band or a ring type called shading ring, and this is the diagram representation which will be a fixed contact. This is your moving contact, this is my disc, spiral, shading ring, copper band, and this is my coil, and this is my magnet. Here the coil will be energized by the current flowing in single coil which is wound on the structure which is containing an air gap. Due to this, a flux will be produced by the current, which is flux splitting up into two in time space and by the shaded ring, and which also encircles the part of pole face of each pole. Here the magnetic field which will develop from the current producing the flux in the portion of iron ring to the lag in phase by 40 degree to 50 degree behind the flux in unshaded portion of the pole. So this is your shaded pole type relay. Next, coming to the watt hour meter relay, main feature of this is opening can be controlled with their operation and closing with secondary winding circuit. If the secondary winding is opened, there will be a no torque will be developed. So this is what your watt hour meter, and main structure consists of E shape. So it is an E shape as well as your U shape electromagnetic with a disc free to rotate in between. So this is our E shape and this is our U shape with a coil, and a flux is producing with the disc to trip the circuit. So this is my upper magnet and this is my lower magnet. Okay, so this secondary coil or secondary winding will be opened, but there will be no torque is produced. Okay, and here with the disc free to rotate, phase displacement between the flux will be obtained from the electromagnet, which is obtained by the flux generated by the two magnets having different resistance and inductance for the two circuits. This E shape will carry two windings, primary and secondary. So primary will carry the relay current I1, and secondary is connected to the winding of U shape electromagnet. Due to this, phi1 will be, that is flux phi1 will be induced in E shape, and while phi is induced in the U shape, which is represented in our previous diagram. So here U shape phi and E shape phi1 is represented. And here the flux induced in the upper, that is in E shape, and produced in U shape lower magnetic differs in the phase angle by the theta. So here the torque produced will be directly proportional to the upper and lower magnetic flux phi1 and phi sine theta. So this is what your watt hour meter, which is obtained as T directly proportional to phi1 phi sine theta. Next, coming to the induction cup type relay, here this mainly works on the principle of electromagnetic induction. Also it has two or more electromagnetic which is energized by the relay coil. So from the circuit diagram given, this coil is wound on the electromagnetic which generates the rotating magnetic field. Because of this rotating magnetic field, current will be induced inside the cup. So this cup starts rotating. Due to this, more torque will be produced in the cup type induction type relay comparing with the other type relay. means shaded and shaded pole type relay and water meter relay. Also, it's a fast operation and its operating time is less than 0.01 seconds. So except this rotor ion, it is a stationary rotor, conductor portion being free to rotate. So this moving element will be hollow cylindrical rotor which turn on its axis. This rotating field produced by the two pair of coils which is wound on the four pole, rotating field inducing the current in cup to provide the necessary driving torque. So if phi 1 and phi 2 represents the flux phi produced by this pair of poles, okay, this pair of poles here, then the torque produced will be directly proportional to the phi 1 phi 2 sine alpha. In this type of induction relay structure, more efficient torque will be produced than the other type, shaded pole as well as the water meter type relay. Main advantage of this type of relay will be there will be an increase in speed and operating time will be less than 0.01 second, as I told already. Okay, so here it is a fast operation. Yes, it's an operating time will be less than the 0.01 second. So overview of this VL video lecture is about type of electromagnetic induction relay, mainly based on shaded water meter and induction cup type relay. And also we saw the elaborate representation of each type of relays, and comparing with the other two type, induction cup type relay will have more efficient in speed as well as more efficient torque produced in this type of relays. Thank you for watching this video.